Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how you can use pivot tables in Numbers to easily summarize data. Now you can use Numbers to create simple spreadsheets to store data. Sometimes you may want to summarize this data by using formulas to add up totals based on the information there. This means using complex formulas, or you could use pivot tables, which might seem more complex, but it's actually simpler. As a matter of fact, you can summarize some complex data in just a few quick steps with no formulas at all. So as a simple example here, here's a list of products and amounts. These could be sales amounts or inventory or whatever. The idea here is that you want to find the totals for each product. So for instance, you want to know how many oranges you've got, even though here you've received 32 oranges, and then later on, you've received 19 and 15 and so on. Now, if you want to sum these up with formulas, you have to create formulas that sum up the oranges and then sum up the pears. And then you have to search through and find out which other products you've got and create formulas for each one of those. Or you can get more complex and figure out which products you've got with some formulas. And then on top of that, use some sum formulas to add them all up. But you can do this with pivot tables with very few steps. So with just this table selected, I'm going to create a pivot table, and I'm going to do it not with the button here in the toolbar, which will create a new sheet with a pivot table, but I'm going to use organize and then create pivot table, where here I can select on current sheet to add a pivot table to this one. Now, since I had this table selected first, it automatically links that table called data to this new pivot table. So all I need to do now is tell the pivot table what to summarize. It just shows the two columns here, product and amount. I'm going to add them both. And when I do, I immediately get a useful summary. You can see here that each row is a product. It figures out which products are listed here and shows each one exactly once. Then the second column shows the sum, the total for every single row with that product. So immediately, I get the summary I want based on this table. I didn't even have to alter anything. But I can go further or modify this if it's not what I want. So for instance, it gives me a grand total here at the bottom. This isn't something I want since these are all different products. So let's get rid of that. Under Organize Pivot Options here, if I go down to Rows and click the three dots button next to it, I can select Hide Grand Total Row, and that gets rid of that. So now this is what I want here, but I would like one more bit of data. I want to know how many times each one of these appears. In other words, how many shipments of each of these products have I received? So I've got my rows here, which are products, and I've got my values here, which are the amounts, this column here, summarized, and it's summarized using a sum. I can add this column a second time. I'm going to drag amount down here and place it a second time. I could put it after this first column or before it. I'm going to do it right before it like that. So now you can see I've got it there twice. I'm going to take that first one, click the I button there, and say summarize not by sum, but by count. So now it's going to count the number of times each one appears. Now I can also sort here if I want to sort by this column here. I can select the little drop-down menu here at the top, say sort values, and I could say sort ascending, so I sort by the counts here. Or I could go into this column here and sort values, and let's say sort descending. So now I can sort with the largest sums first. And the great thing about this is it will update somewhat automatically. I don't have to change anything to update this. So I can add another row here, and I'll add 10 more apples here in another shipment. Now, this doesn't update by itself. I have to select the pivot table and then click this button here, and you'll watch apples change to 11 and 455 when I do that. And you can see it does it here. It will also make me reassert the sort, but I didn't have to add any new formulas. As a matter of fact, notice that I didn't use formulas at all in doing all of this. So I got some really useful information perhaps all that I need, without having to type a single formula or understand a single function. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MACMOST at Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. Here's another example. So here are some test results for students in a class. I've entered these in as records in a database. So instead of having the quizzes going across in different columns, I simply have each one as a record, the student's name and their grade. And there are many different quizzes here, the same student taking many different quizzes over time. Now, if I wanted to summarize this and find out how each student is doing, I may have to do another table with some complex formulas. Or with this table selected here, I can go to Organize, create pivot table on current sheet, and I'm going to add student and grade here, and it's going to give me each student, and it's going to give me the sum of their grades, which isn't useful. What I want is the average, so I'll click the information button next to the grade here, and I will change that to average. Now, I'm going to get all these decimal places here. That's fine, because you can format cells in a pivot table just like you can in a regular table. So with this selected, I'll go to the format sidebar here, go to cell, and I'll change it to number, and then change the number of decimals to, let's say, 0 here, but I could do 1 if I wanted to. So I get a grade like that. Now, I've got the grade average here. Let's say I also want to check to make sure that each student has taken each quiz or that I've remembered to record them all. So I will add a second time here, the grade, and I put that before, and like before, I will set that not to sum here, but to the count. So you could see here, each student has taken 7 quizzes, so I know that I'm not missing any data, and no student is missing a grade, and then I've got the average here, and I can sort by the values if I want here to see which students are doing well and which aren't. And then I can see the average grade here for everybody. Here's a more complex example. Let's say you trade stocks. The tricky thing about trading stocks is you may purchase the same stock multiple times. So just seeing the current value of a stock, it's hard to judge how well you're doing because a purchase from a long time ago might be doing well, but a recent purchase may not be doing well. So I've got all these different stock trades here. Each one has a recorded purchase date, the price it was purchased at, how much was purchased, and then a simple formula here just to multiply these two together to get the purchase value. Then it's going to use the stock function here to get the current price, and the current value is, again, multiplying the amount owned by the current price to get a gain or loss for that particular purchase. But as you can see here, each stock has multiple purchases. So you kind of want to get an idea of how each stock is doing, how each of your holdings is doing. And you can do that with a pivot table. So with this table selected here, I'm going to do like I did before, organize, create pivot table on the current sheet. And I'm going to add just some things here. I'm going to add the stock. So now I get each stock listed once. And I'm also going to add the gain loss amount, like that. So this is how much each one is gained and lost summed. So if, for instance, I've made multiple purchases of Apple stock, some have gained, some have lost, depending upon when I bought, this is the total now reflected for all of those. But I have tons of data here that I could summarize. So as an example, I may want to look at the purchase amount here. Let's add that. And that's going to sum those all up. So I can see how much of each stock I own. And in this case, the grand total here is actually very useful. I can see how many stock shares of everything I own and my total here, which includes these negatives in here. So I know my total holdings. So you can see how pivot tables in numbers can actually be simpler than using formulas and help you see things in your data very easily. Hope you find this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.